we'll see about the Newton's third law. See, to every action there is always an equal and opposite reaction. What is the heading here? Newton's third law. Okay, this law is very very important, Newton's third law. Okay, what is the Newton's third law? To every action there is always an equal and opposite reaction will be exist. Based on these principles, there are many examples or many phenomena will be exist. Let us take best example, the jet rocket is there. What happened? The jet rocket is moving forward, the energy or fog is coming back. Like that there are many examples will be there. So let us see this. If we see what happened, suppose one action is going on like this. So what happened? Every action, this is one action, there is always equal and opposite reaction. So if it is going like this, F1, then what happen? Another reaction. So if it is existing like this, then what happen? Equal and, which is, what is there in between? Equal. Then what we can write? F1 is equal to F2. Then what is the next one? Opposite. So what we can write? So F1 is equal to minus F2. Okay, this tells about the Newton's third law. Or else, let us take in this direction, F. In your textbook like this, they have taken FAB is equal to, what we can write? Minus FBA we can write. This is also same statement. Every action, there is always an equal and opposite reaction will be exist. FAB is equal to, what we can write? Minus FBA. Then what happen? FAB plus FBA is equal, what we can write? Simply we can write the zero. Many example means jet rocket is working on this principle, this principles. Like that there are many example will be exist. Okay, you are going forward, the reactions will come backward. Based on this principle only the our vehicle is running, there are many applications will be exist. Next we will see about the momentum. What is the momentum? Already I said about momentum. Now we are going to see momentum and conservation of momentum. Okay, next, momentum. Okay, the momentum. So now what is my moment? My moment is at rest position. Okay, let us take consider one object. Myself is object, or else body, my object is my object has mass. Okay, mass is there. Okay, I consider myself is object, I am having mass. Okay, what is my position? What is my moment? There is no moment. Now moment is there. What happened? I changed from one place to another place, I acquired some velocity. Then what we can say, moment means the product of mass and velocity. The product of mass and velocity, then we can say is called momentum. Momentum. Okay, momentum is denoted by small p. Then what we can write? P is equal to mv. Okay, next we are going to write the measurements. M is equal, first we'll write the SI, next we'll write the SI means kg, next to meter per second, this is the SI unit. Next, R, grams, centimeter by second, this is CGS unit. Okay, simply momentum, there are two measurements will be exist, one is SI unit, another one is CGS unit. SI unit kg, meter per seconds, or CGS if you want to gram, centimeter by seconds. Okay, when you are solving problems, if the problem itself they are given MKS, means you have to consider all MKS. You can do either MKS method or CGS method according to according to situation, you have to take this values. Next one, conservation of momentum. when the momentum will be conserved.